Manila's finance chief Benjamin Diokno says the Maharlika Investment Fund is making headway despite a legal challenge before the Supreme Court. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel and former Bayan Muna Party List representatives filed a petition Monday asking the High Court to declare the Sovereign Wealth Fund unconstitutional. They argue the law is a disaster waiting to happen because it did not go through a test of economic viability. Diokno says government will first study the petition before issuing a response.
We will respond to the petition at the right time, in the right place. No? Pinag-aaralan na yan ng Office of the Solicitor General. Siya yung magiging abogado namin dyan. At saka yung mga ni-raise nila na issues na yan, na-raise na rin nila during the deliberation. Nag-iikot din kami sa buong mundo, in fact, kagagaling lang namin sa Middle East, para maingganyo nga na mag-invest doon sa Maharlika Investment. Pero we have more than 100 billion na. We have actually identified some 197 top priority projects. Mm. Napakalaking amount na kailangan ipundo natin. Kasama na dyan, of course, some of the ongoing projects katulad ng mga yung subway, mga train, etc., bridges linking one province to another. So, kailangan natin ng pera para doon.
No? Apo,
okay, so ang rate of return noon, at least 10% internal rate of return noon. Some project na yan, some will give 25% return, some 30%, 50%.
The National Bureau of Investigation recommends the filing of cases against several individuals, including government officials, for the alleged hoarding of onions that caused prices to spike, Nico Bawa reports.
The NBI Anti-Organized and Transnational Crimes Division submitted to the Department of Justice the findings of its probe on the surge in onion prices. The Bureau recommended cases against three officials of the Department of Agriculture and the chairman of Bonena Multipurpose Cooperative, Israel Reguyal, and two of his traders. The charges include violation of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act and the Philippine Competition Act, hoarding, profiteering, unfair or unconscionable sales act or practice, technical malversation, falsification of private documents, use of falsified documents, and inefficiency and incompetence as public officials were also recommended. Some stakeholders stood as witnesses. They requested the DA and the BPI to import onions last August 2022 since they knew that stocks were already low. But the DA did not import onions.
Question namin bakit hindi sila nagpasok ng time ng September. Ang sabi ni Glenn is dahil yun nga, yung grupo ni Israel ang nagsabing huwag na magpasok ng puting sibuyas. Sinabi naman ni Israel at that time, doon sa meeting na yun, kasi may mga pulang sibuyas pa kami.
To mitigate the waning supply, the DA procured onions from Reguyal of the Bonena Multipurpose Cooperative at 537 pesos per kilo last December, which was sold in Kadiwa stores at 170 pesos per kilo. But members of the cooperative explained to the NBI that they had nothing to do with the procurement and that their records were falsified.
Pagsamantalahan yung kooperatiba. Yung masakit kasi nagamit yon, nakipag-deal sa ganito na hindi namin alam. Wala kaming kaalam-alam talaga.
Based on the DA's records, two onion suppliers competed with Reguyal for the procurement contract. But that was far from the truth.
May tinatawag na procurement mode, no? So ang minimum kasi, 3 bidders dapat. So ang 3 bidders actually, iisa lang yung gumawa ng 3 bids, no? And nag-falsify sila ng documents, malinaw, na yung dalawang supposedly other bidders, hindi alam na sumama sila sa bid.
The investigation also questioned why the DA agreed to Reguyal's offer of 537 pesos per kilo of onions when the records of the Philippine Statistics Authority showed that the price of onions was at 305 pesos per kilo that time.
Sila po ay talagang lumalabas na mayroong pungsala sa pagkakataong ito. At hindi pa, ito'y simula pa lang, marami pa hong kasong ipafile. At tuloy-tuloy po yung imbestigasyon ng NBI.
ABS-CBN News sought the side of Reguyal but he has yet to give a statement. The DA has yet to comment on the NBI's findings. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says they will still evaluate the recommendations of the NBI. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.
Manila's finance chief calling on proposals to suspend VAT and excise taxes on fuel short-sighted. See, there have been growing calls to suspend tax on fuel after local pump prices went up for an 11th straight week. Secretary Benjamin Diokno warns government stands to lose over 280 billion pesos in revenues if that suggestion is implemented. He adds the move might cripple the economy.
Ang ibig sabihin niyan, kung hindi natin babawasan yung spending dahil mawalan ng revenues pero tuloy-tuloy yung paggastos natin, lalaki yung deficit mo, di ba? Lalaki yun from 6.1 magiging 6.4 ang deficit mo, percent of GDP. Pag lumaki yun, lalaki rin yung utang mo. Lalaki rin yung utang mo eh kasi mangungutang ka para tustusan yung kawalan ng revenues from 61.4% of GDP magiging 61.7%. Ang mangyayari niyan, mawawalan ng kumpiyansa yung, di ba, yung mga credit rating natin. Right now, kaganda-ganda nga ng credit rating natin, investment grade, no? Pagka nawalan yung ano yun, matataas ang interest ng panghihiram natin as a government.
The Energy Department, for its part, called on oil companies to do their part to help the affected transport sector.
Hindi naman ganun kasi kadalian kasi it's a collegial body na tapos kailangan may approval of the House of Representatives and then Senate. Ang isang immediate na solution would be yung mga assistance sa mga drivers sa mga oil companies na baka pwede naman sila tumulong din sa gobyerno kahit tatlong buwan lang kasi ang expected nito is the next 3 months medyo mataas pa rin ang presyo ng gas. Hindi naman nalulugi yung mga oil companies natin. It's a small sacrifice or a short-term sacrifice for our oil companies.
Finance Secretary Ben Diokno hits back at calls urging him to step down. See, several agricultural groups are calling for his resignation, together with National Economic and Development Chief Arsenio Balisacan, over their rice tariff policies. But Diokno insists he only supports policies that are for the good of the country.
I serve at the pleasure of the president. Kung ayaw na sa akin yung Pangulo, pwede naman niya ako tagalin. Ganun lang naman yan eh. I have served for president. Hindi naman porque meron kang proposal na hindi ka angkop doon sa proposal ng ibang grupo, magre-resign ka na, di ba? You give your best recommendation. That is your duty.
Government's anti-insurgency task force forced to stop its own press conference after two activists whom government claims surrendered to authorities revealed they were abducted and illegally detained by the military and police. Jonila Castro and Jet Tamano made that claim when they were presented by the NTF-LCAC this morning. Listen to what Castro had to say.
Binili na namin na magsalita ngayong araw para katulad ka ng sinabi kanina, mahalagang malaman natin kung ano yung totoo talagang nangyari. At gusto namin ang tanong na dinukot ba kami o kusa kaming voluntaryo kaming sumurrender. Ang totoo po eh, dinukot kami ng mga militar sa kainang van. Napilitan din kami na sumurrender. Dahil pinagbantaan yung buhay namin. Yun po ang totoo. Hindi rin namin ginusto na mapunta kami sa kustodya ng mga militar.
The press conference was immediately stopped and the live feed of that event has since been deleted. But not before the video was downloaded by media and some progressive groups. Rights groups had cast a doubt on government's earlier claim the two environmentalists who went missing September 2nd had surrendered to a military unit in Bulacan last September 12. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya had claimed Castro and Tamano abandoned the leftist movement on their own free will.